Hello everyone, and welcome back to a short reviews video for June 2021. This is about those albums or EPs that came out the previous month that I don't really feel I had that many things to talk about them. It's about some releases that I thought were okay, others not so much, some of them might be more to your liking, and all of those are put together in this monthly section. And with that being said, let's just jump straight into the video. Little Big released a short EP with a series of covers, which in my opinion, first of all, I'm never really that much into covers material. I rarely see the appeal of them, and this basically just contains silly rave versions of songs. Like, the latest material of Little Big are extremely hit or miss for me. Many of the songs they do nowadays just sound like really silly and obnoxious, and they try so hard to be funny, like it feels so forceful trying to be funny, and they end up just being quite unfunny. And so yeah, for me this is a release that I didn't really enjoy that much. This is just a basic and average Japanese breakfast album, and that's all about it. Like, I don't really have words for this. It feels bland, it's just a mediocre release. Honestly, could have been worse in my opinion. It's still not good. I mean, as the album starts, there are some songs that I listen to them and I'm like, okay, this feel kinda cool. But once again, why is this album so long? Why is there so much material in this album? It's so unnecessary. There's so much filler to it. And even if it is shorter than Culture 2, it still doesn't feel like they learned their lesson. This is a bloated album. There is so much unnecessary stuff to it. And at the end of the day, who really asked for this? Were people still hyped for a new Migos project? Because I remember just talking about this album being released over and over again. And it took so much time that I just felt that after a while it just became irrelevant. I don't know, I certainly do not see the appeal of Migos anymore. This is just another really basic trap project from them. I honestly do admire how King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard changed their style and their sound so many different times, and they constantly release so much new material in such a short period of time. However, for me, like I said, there are many occasions where I don't really feel that many of the directions they've gone have worked. I honestly kinda enjoyed the two previous albums that went into this Anatolian rock side, and this is another different direction from the band where it goes into some more synth-pop directions, but in my opinion this didn't work. As far as I was somewhat excited to see the results, for me this ends up becoming one of the most boring albums from the band. Like, seriously, for me, this is one of my least favorite albums they've released. I cannot remember anything about this album. This was just a snooze fest for me. Cold Cave made their comeback after many years only to release an album that it's pretty much basically sort of the same with their previous stuff. Now, the thing is that I've actually never really been that much of a huge Cold Cave fan. It's one of those post-punk bands that actually managed to become pretty popular, but I don't really see them trying something new, something different, or even being that great in what they do. And for me, this is basically another basic and standard post-punk album without that much to it. What I really love about the Sewer Slut works is the extremely dark, depressing and melancholic atmosphere. But when it comes to a full project, once again I feel that there are some pretty engaging moments and others that in my opinion could have been executed better. I still see potential, but honestly some of those moments are not that much in my cup of tea, and I just believe that at points the album could have been better, especially when it comes to some of the hardcore breaks, because in some of them the mixing is not really that great. I would love for some of those moments to become more engaging and more powerful, which is something that I rarely see. When it comes to the atmosphere, this is where the album really stands out, but this album in its entirety, I hope it would be more compelling. I was kinda curious to listen to this EP considering that two of the three members are Aaron Funk and John Frusciante, but can't really say I enjoyed this release as much as I expected. I think that for what it does, it has some decent moments. I think that there are occasions where you have some interesting sounds, but it feels like a really bland and basic breakcore release. Now, I believe that this is supposed to be a Black to Come remix project of Senyawa's newest album, and I believe that it kinda shares the elements that the original offered, But as a full experience, this album was extremely forgettable to me. It was one of those instances where Black to Come, in my opinion, can do some pretty intriguing stuff with some of the instrumentals and just invoking a dark and haunting atmosphere. But I really do not think that this release is worth your time. I didn't really know what to expect out of this, but it was certainly not that. Back was his back, and I do get why people are super excited with this release and the results. There is certainly some pretty interesting material in this release, and I like the aggression, and I think that some of the instrumentals are pretty good. But it's just a shorter release that it doesn't really do that much for me. I think that it could have been developed even further in some occasions, have some more expansive tracks, a bit of a more material to it, but for what it is, I just think that this is a pretty good release. This album goes from being an absolute snooze fest to one of the most epic and powerful releases of the year, if only we would have more of the latter. What's pretty interesting about Doja Cat's music is in how many different directions it has gone with her sound over the years. I mean, in many occasions it hasn't really done to some amazing results, but I honestly liked her previous album Hot Pink in some occasions. This one for the most part, Planet Hair, feels more like a pretty average Latin pop and pop rap album that at some cases it's good, at others it's a bit obnoxious. It is a bit of a mixed bag and a pretty average album in my opinion. Do people honestly even care anymore? It has been a few years since Ski Mask the Slum God released something and he just comes up with a mixtape that it's only what, like 17 minutes long and that's it? And we're talking about some of his worst material, especially when it comes to the production and the mixing. It sounds really bad. This mixtape contains some of his worst beats. And on top of that, we're talking about another project that basically has so many ideas that feel unfinished. So yeah, kinda feels like a completely irrelevant and forgettable project. On one hand, it does have to do with the fact that I don't really enjoy stuff like this. You know, this pretty standard Latin pop direction that this brand new Pablo Vittar album has. But in my opinion, honestly, at some occasions, I could see that there could have been some potential. But for the most part, I really didn't care about this album whatsoever. I can see people like it. It's definitely not my cup of tea. This is an album that pretty much has some of the characteristics that we see in Old Star and with also some of the previous albums, and it also adds a few of the crust punk elements that we see in 2000's Dark Throne. Now, considering that I loved Old Star and I truly find it to be one of my all-time favorite Dark Throne releases, you would expect that I would obviously be super excited for a brand new Dark Throne release, but that wasn't really the case. I did not get into Internal Hails expecting much, because for me, All Star felt for me as a one-kind deal. It was a quite special and engaging experience for me, so I wasn't really surprised that Internal Hails wasn't really that much of a groundbreaking experience. From just my very first listen, I just ended up not really remembering many of the riffs or finding the experience to be that much captivating. I found the main issue with the two first tracks where I would have so many pause notes to an overwhelming amount where I would feel that it just makes the tracks sound pretty empty. In my opinion, if it would just let the chords breathe, it would make for a much better experience and for an album that just sounds more alive. Also, there's basically a lack of black metal elements in this album. The instrumentals mostly go into a heavy doom direction, so the vocals, which are basically the most black metal part about this album, are not really all that fitting in my opinion. Other than that, for the most part, you're basically getting the basic experience of a new era Dark Throne album, and it's simply okay, and that's pretty much all about it. And that's all I have for the short reviews for June 2021. What's your opinion in any of those albums or EPs? Like them, dislike them, why, and what do you want me to review next time? Let me know down in the comments. Leave a like if you enjoyed the video, subscribe for more content like this. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video. Goodbye.